now we're going to talk about form processing in PHP. PHP's goal is not just as a programming language, but it's a programming language to implement web applications. And so it takes some effort, puts effort into making dealing with things like forms in HTML as easy as possible. And the way it does this is these super global variables. It takes things like parameters on the URL and post data and puts them in what are called super globals. And the reason they call them super globals, and they give them a name like dollar underscore get, is that even inside of functions, these are present. You do not have to use the global keyword to get at them. And so they're sort of decided from the outside in that it's global. You can make a global variable in a function if you want, as we've talked about, but these super globals are sort of automatically made global. And so we talked about this in the last section where we, you know, we took a look at the get data, you put a parameter on the end of a URL, and that is copied nicely into the key value pairs in the dollar underscore get. And we can use something like print r and var dump, of course we enclose them in pre-tags, to take a look at what's in this. So if you look at how this works on the request response cycle, you know, you click with the URL, it goes in, the get with x equals 2 shows up, that goes into the web server, which parses the request and pulls these values off as key value pairs. And there's actually lots of rules for what these things are formatted. X equals 2 is just the simplest of them. And then the super global array dollar get is produced, and it is created before the first line of your code starts. And then, of course, we are doing the printout, and it comes back, and we see that. And so that's just part of the infrastructure that's provided to us by PHP. Now, the web would be kind of boring if we always just had to put these parameters on. So there are many ways to send this kind of parameter data into a web script running on the server. And one of them is a form. And so form is an HTML tag. Starts with form and ends with slash form. And effectively, there's this input tag which creates open little boxes. So you basically say, oh, put a place for the user to type something, an input area of text, and the name, and the name will end up be part of the key value pairs that are submitted. And ID is actually part of the CSS, which says that if I want to access this form, I'm going to use the ID of guest. So name, this part is for the server, and this part here is for CSS. Now, one of the things that you do is you put these labels in. The label is just a tag to say that this information is the label for that, and that's useful for screen readers and other things. So a text field opens up a little box here, and the submit field says send the data to the server, which is kind of like an href, an anchor tag. It's like clicking on the text, the anchor tag, so it causes a request response cycle to go in to the browser, to the server, from the browser to the server. So when the form is we go first to this web page, and we take a look at the information. We kind of, come back. We take a look at the information. It comes down, it paints the form, and it paints this. And then we move our cursor in, and we type 12, and then we press the submit button. And then that submits back to that same URL, except now it adds the parameter guess equals 12. And that guess came from this parameter, and the 12 came from what we typed in. And so that's how, using a GET request, data is moved from a form into the server. Now, form1.php runs on the server, and PHP parses it and puts it in $GET, and all that other stuff. It's just a way to get the parameters off of the screen rather than teaching the user to type stuff up in here. Okay? So, this is that code that we're doing. we can see what the GET array is, and the GET array is this global array. This is kind of review because we've already seen this in the previous lecture, but we'll just print it out. And the field that starts here ends up on there. The name is guess, and then it is parsed and put into the $get. And this name guess ends up as part of the $get array, and the value, whatever the 12 is that you put in here, ends up here. And so that's how you take a user input area and get it into your program via a GET request. So up next, we're going to talk about the other way that we send data in from other than a GET request, and that is the POST request.